Hey everyone, thanks for coming in tonight. Happy Tuesday. Hope all is well with you guys. Hey replay viewers, thanks for watching. And thanks YouTube viewers. This will go live, not live, this will go up to YouTube when we're done here at Penguin and Fish Movies. And it'll stay here on the Penguin and Fish Facebook page. So here we are, guys. We have a free day today, so we are going to work on the cute little dress some more. We're done with the dress. We're going to move on to all the other bits, this little spool of thread and the little needle. We'll do the needle today first. So, all right, guys, I'm going to flip you around and we'll get going tonight. Hey, Wanda. Hey, everyone. Thanks for coming in. It is Tuesday, and we got done with our... It is Tuesday, right? It's one of those days that I'm just kind of spacing out on the day, so I think it's Tuesday. So we are working on block 28 some more, this cute little dress. So we have the dress done. We're going to work on the rest of it, so I think tonight we'll start with this little needle. This is super teeny tiny. We'll use the add an eighth ruler for that. And we'll use the add a quarter for the rest of it, I think. We'll see how it goes. But that's the plan for tonight. We had a free day, meaning we basically just got our Sunday's block done early. And we have today and tomorrow to work on other blocks before New Block Thursday for the Splendid Sampler. So you can find out more at thesplendidsampler.com. And if you're new here, my name is Alyssa Thomas from Penguin and Fish, where we make lovely and quirky hand embroidery patterns and kits. I'm the author of Sew and Stitch Embroidery and a Fabric Designer, and I'm here every night at 9:30 p.m. Central. So, all right, guys, let's flip around and get going tonight. Hey, Internet. All right, here we are, guys. Internet, tell me, is that how you, do you go by your name, like Antoinette, or do you go by Tony, or let me know. I'll try and do my best to learn everyone. Hey, Susan. All right, so dress is done. We finished that up on, I think, Saturday, or I don't know, recently. So let's move on to M. So this has these itty bitty teeny tiny guys in here. And then M1. So this is our first piece. We're going to just kind of whip through this. We've been doing a lot of paper piecing recently. I mean, I'll still kind of explain what we're doing, but, you know, and if you have a question, ask for sure. But be sure to check out, you know, some of the other videos of paper piecing. Some of the first videos, I get into it a little bit more. Antoinette and Tony. Okay, good to know. Thanks. Thanks for clarifying. All right. So here's the colors I'm going to use. I'm going to use this blue for the needle. I thought that would be cute. And then, you know, we're still using this background fabric. So it'll be like a little sliver. Here's a little sliver. It'll be like a little sliver of this blue on top of this darker blue. I think it'll look okay. It'll be a little bit more of a sliver. So I think we'll be able to see it. Or maybe, I don't know. Do you guys think I should go lighter than this? Maybe not light enough. I think we're going to deal with it. We're going to use it. So, all right, that is the first, that's the first thing, M1. So we're going to start by cutting a piece. Oh, look, I think we'll do it right here. We're going to need a piece of fabric that is as big as this M1 piece, plus our generous seam allowance around. So one thing we have to remember about the dress block is that our seam allowances on the edge are not included. So we have to remember the generous seam allowance on the edge as well. Hey, Judith, thanks for coming in. So that's something specific about the dress block. And you know, this is like a lot of paper piecing blocks. Not all of them are gonna have your seam allowance built in, but it's been kind of atypical for our Splendid Sampler so far. So, all right, I think, ooh, maybe this is gonna need more space than I think we need. I think if we go like right there, we'll have a pretty good seam allowance. We want bigger than a quarter inch, so I kind of go almost a half inch. I think if I just loop around like this, we'll probably be good to go. I'm gonna do it with the scissors, I think. So generous seam allowance. I like a little, you know, almost a half an inch. I'll be so glad when you get the dress done. Oh, but you have this one. Oh, you have this one done. Yeah, my mom got this one done right away, and it's one of my favorites of hers. Let me just snip this up like that. And it has been hanging. This is my second oldest unfinished block. So this Saturday when I do like that mini marathon, I wanted to do kind of all paper piecing, just keep it full on paper piecing because I got a lot of those yet. But I still have 26. So this is block 28. 26 is my actual oldest unfinished block. So I'm going to put the teeniest dab of glue on this needle area just to hold it in place. Just doing it small because this needle is so skinny. So this is definitely less than a quarter inch in size, this needle. So I think this is probably good for my generous seam allowance all the way done. Oh, red is your color? I feel like, have you guys heard of the website? It's like a clothing website called Mod Cloth, M-O-D Cloth. I feel like this would be a dress that they'd sell on there for sure. Oh, you made two of these. Oh, you put the spool needle on the wrong side. It'll look good on either side for sure. I think the needle. All right, M1 is basically done at this point after we've glued it down. Yep, the needle is one piece, but we have these tiny little bits up here that shape the top of the needle. So, I mean, those are really, really tiny. So let's get up close. Let's look at that. So here we are. So the needle is on. Luckily, we colored it in too. This is just so we can remember what's what. But now we're doing M2, which is this tiny of tiny pieces. And that will be done with our background fabric. And you know what? We must have a scrap of that we can use. Let's check that out. Oh, several people put it on the wrong side. You know, it's funny because when you're working on it in reverse like this all the time, you get used to it being on a side. So when you flip it around, it's kind of awkward being on the other side. Okay, good. Look, we do have some scraps. Let me see if I have any more of that blue. I think we might have gotten a bunch of that out last time I dug through here, though. So it might just be that. So that'll be plenty fine for these itty bitty tiny triangles. So, all right, first things first, let's do the postcard. Here we are. So I'm going to cover up that M1. Let's get all my fabric out of the way so I don't cut it on accident. Oh, yeah, these itsy bitsy pieces, they barely exist. Okay, so we're working on this M2 piece, which is that tiny, tiny, tiny piece here. M3 is actually a hair smaller. And I'm going to cover up M1, and we're going to ignore everything else. So I'm going to ignore that M4 is there. I'm just going to fold on here. Wow. I wonder if this is going to work well. We'll just have to see. So in this case, you know, usually I've been using this add a quarter ruler. But in this case, like when you're working with really small pieces, I am going to use the add an eighth ruler, although I think this isn't even going to really matter either. The reason to use a smaller one is because then you won't be sewing together like four layers of fabric because your seam allowance is included in it. But this piece is so small that I don't think it's even going to matter us using the add an eighth. But, you know, we got it, so why don't we try using it? So the difference here, same thing with a lip, but the lip is an eighth inch instead. Yeah, it's gonna just, I don't think this even matters that we're using the smaller seam allowance just because it is just gonna, it's still gonna be doubled up. But anyway, let's give it a try. So there's our tiny eighth inch seam allowance. Flip this back, and now we need our tiny piece of fabric. And you know what? What I'm gonna do, I'm just gonna cut. These are gonna be way bigger than we need. But you know what? They're still so tiny, and that's what I'm gonna use. So I don't wanna have to move this around or sew it more than once or anything, so I'm just cutting my big piece. Let's just match up the right sides to, oop, right side together. Woo! Jeez, almost messed that up. Just with the straight edge, and we're gonna just sew that. I know this piece is huge, but it's still pretty tiny. So, all right, let's go over to the machine. Pretty dress can hang out with us. Okay, I still have this set up with the smaller stitch length. The one with the ball, yeah, so the one with the ball, I think it will actually, the balls in the air paper pieced one, I think that one we might actually benefit from this add a quarter ruler because they're not quite so small. So I think this eighth inch will be good for there. Here, like I said, I don't think it matters because it is such, it's so small that it's smaller than that eighth inch. So we're going to get our doubled up seam allowance no matter what we do. Oh, you think of this as your guild? That's cool. I don't belong to a guild either. And you know what? I love going to quilt guilds because it's so neat to see what everyone's making. Like, that's what I love about it. The show and tell part. All right, I'm going to sew into that seam allowance too that doesn't exist. You know, we're adding that seam allowance. So I'm going to sew into that fake seam allowance. But I don't actually belong to a guild. I used to be a part of the Minneapolis guild here, but there's my little scissors. Here we go. But I just couldn't ever, I just didn't have time to participate in anything, so I felt bad. So I kind of stopped going. But yeah, this is kind of like a little quilt guild. We get to sew and try new things and stuff. All right. So I did my little trimming. I like trimming that right away, and let's press this open and see what happens here. We're carving this little needle out of here, which is kind of crazy. It is so small. All right, putting face down so I don't get that toner on my iron, and I think this might have to wake up a little bit. Oh, it's pretty hot. Okay, so I'm gonna flip it and just press where we sewed, finger press where we sewed there. And then I'll kind of extend that finger pressing down the edge here. Ooh, I think the contrast is enough. I think this is light enough that we'll be able to see it. I wasn't quite sure if that blue was light enough, but I think it'll be good. So, okay. So, there's our needle so far. Two giant blobs. All right. Let's continue. We're not, I don't think we'll be able to tell this until we get it all together and trimmed what's going on here. But, all right, let's do that M3. So the M3 is even smaller than the M2, or I don't know, maybe it's about the same. But let's do that. I already have that piece cut out, which is the Alyssa International Quilt Guild. Exactly, that's awesome. Sounds good to me. All right, postcard, where'd you go? All right, so I'm covering up, I'm exposing the M3, covering up everything that came before, and ignoring everything that's coming after. But oh my gosh, this is so small. How am I gonna fold this? Ah, okay, so little. All right, I'll try to add an eighth ruler again, but I think after this, I might switch back to the add a quarter. All right. Did we get cut out there for a second there? My screen went black for a little. Yes, and Kitty Black is our emblem. That should happen. All right. There we go. Tiny little seam allowance. So, do most readers watch or so on? Oh, that's a good question. I'd love to hear that. I know some of you sew every once in a while. Here. All right, so I just trimmed right there. So this is our next piece, matching it up. Oh my gosh, it's so little. All right, well, there we are. Let's give that a try. And then we'll do the sew and watch, yay. Sometimes I watch watch Facebook Lives and then do laundry, fold laundry and do that. Okay, let's try and get this tiny little bit. I'm gonna start in the seam allowance and then come down into the block and meet up with that edge. So here we are. All right, little back tack, and there we go. Oh, you fall asleep to me. That's hilarious. Oh, goodness. All right. Here we are. I'm going to trim these little guys. Oh, my gosh. It's past midnight by you. Wow. You guys are hardcore. All right. I think I got all these. Oh, no. I got a little trimming down here. Oh my gosh, 3:30 in the morning, man, you get up early, holy cow. Alright, we should start to see a little point happening here now, so that's going to be the tip of our needle. Let's give it a go over here on the iron. Oof, yeah, let's set the seam a little. That's way beyond early for me, for sure. Alright. I think that's how it wants to lay. Let's press that. Oh, that's cool. That's neat that you guys tried so long. But definitely, you don't have to, for sure. Alright, so there's that little point. So, alright, it's starting to be a needle. That's nice, Marianne. I'm glad I could be soothing. I'm not sure that's how. I don't know. Everyone would call my voice. Alright, M1, 2, 3, let's do M4. Oh, this way you feel like your blocks are done, or it feels like you're 17 behind, or wait, no, I think I'm only 15 behind now, actually, right? Because we finished the two on the Saturday. I think we're only 15 behind now. That's crazy town. All right, let's do this piece here. Wow, we got to get this skinny point. Man, this is going to be a little kind of crazy here, but we're on M4, so this is a little bit bigger of a piece that we can deal with. I'm going to switch back to that add a quarter ruler. I think there's just a little more leeway when you have that quarter of an inch if you move around a little bit compared to the add an eighth. So I think I'm done with the add an eighth for now. And we might bring back the add an eighth for these other guys once we get that far. But all right, ruler cutter. There, we're back to the quarter inch. Oh, you got a bunch done Sunday? That's nice. Your husband's asleep. All right. There we go. All right. M4. So let's get this fabric going. This looks like as good place as any. All right. So I need a piece that's as big as this. You know what? We have a more triangular area. Oh. Maybe up here. All right, I could go right there, and that'd be pretty good. Remember, I have to add the generous seam allowance on this side, too. I do need to cut this as a nice straight edge, so why don't I start there? I'm going to cut it, like, right here. Oh, your daughter's name, Melissa. That's nice. Okay, oops. There we go. Alright, that's a little scrap we might be able to use later. Alright, now I have my good straight edge here that I can kind of put that fold on just to kind of measure a good, decent piece. And I think right there will do. I'm gonna just cut my my generous seam allowance, and I'm going to be more generous than usual just because I'm freaked out. But there we go. Here's our blob. So now I just have to match up right sides together on that seam. And that should do the job. And you know what? I don't think I'm going to even test this. I think, you know, we'll do our little fake test here. Yeah, we'll be plenty fine right there, I think. All right. So let's flip this around and sew. Oh, Tuesday's your favorite TV night. I listen to both. That's funny. What's on TV? That's so good on Tuesdays. Let's flip this around. All right, I think we'll start at the bottom here. Try not to move that needle fabric because we're only glued up here. I don't want it to move around all over the place. So I'm going to start in the seam allowance again. Remember, the seam allowance isn't drawn on, so I'm starting in the actual fabric here, and I'm going to try and connect up this needle and attempt to sew as straight as I can. So we have a nice, sharp, edged needle. All right, here we go! Oh, NCIS, bull. NCIS, there's like so many NCISs. All right, so I'm sewing all the way up through to the seam allowance on top here. And, whoa, I think my machine ate it a little, but luckily we're in the seam allowance, so it's okay. We're gonna be pretty busy up top here. I think I'm gonna trim it just like that. All right, trim this bottom area. Wow, this thread matches this back of this fabric really well. It's hard to see. Oh, seriously, dude. Man, oh my gosh. There's so many of those. All right. Up top. Can't pick it up. All right, let's give it a press and see what we got. We're starting to see that little needle pop through here, I think. Just one more piece on this guy, then we can trim it, and needle's done then. I think we can start on another piece yet tonight. Okay, it still looks crazy, but there's the start of our needle. Up top here, you can see where we carve that little edge of the needle. So now we're just gonna put that last little bit in. All right, last piece is right now M5. So postcard, get a nice edge on there. All right, and add a corner. Hide it up top. All those pieces. And okay. M5. Let's see if we can find another little triangular area out of here. I don't want to cut any of my extra stuff. I think right here would probably be a great area. How straight is this? Okay, we're gonna have to any mix out of here? No. I'll have to trim this straight, but other than that, I think this looks pretty great. Let's use the scissors this time. I'm doing an excess amount again, just because it still does make me nervous. I don't want to have to redo it, so I'm going my generous seam allowance, and you know what, we'll just trim it up like that. So this is a little different. If you guys were watching the airplane block, from the other day that we just finished yesterday, That we did a little different process, and the only thing that really made it different, I need to find out what angle I needed to cut this at. The only thing that made it different is we kind of cut all our pieces all at once from, we printed out an extra copy of our template here, of all these, and cut all the pieces out beforehand. So that's different. I haven't done that before. It's not different, it's just different to me prepping all the pieces beforehand. So this is what we're doing now, this going blob by blob. This is kind of how I usually end up doing it. And it works fine too, but it was kind of nice having all those things pre-cut. I'm going fast tonight. I think, you know, we're back to our tiny pieces, which is kind of nice. And, you know, maybe I'm not explaining stuff as much tonight either. You guys are all old pros at all this paper piecing stuff now, right? All right. Yeah, we did get into it a little bit more yesterday and the day before. But yeah, trying to cruise through this a little bit. We're back to the small pieces, though. I think that might be part of it. Small pieces are nice. Yeah, lay it on a measure. I kind of like that we can skip all the prep. Although, you know, once you have it all prepped, it's nice because then it gets done fast. But it is nice. I don't know. This still takes the thinking away from it, I think. You can just relax and not have to prep, not have to plan so much. All right, the thing I want for sure to happen is that I sew right, that I get this point in this exact spot where this other sewing happened, or, you know, as close as I can, so we can get a nice sharp point to the needle. And I think I went over it a little bit, but oh well, that's how it's gonna be. So let's see it. This is it for the needle. Flip it around. All right, just gonna trim these little ends off. All right, just pressing and trimming around it. Then we'll have our needle ready to go. That wasn't too bad. I was thinking that'd be a lot more difficult. Oh yes, you don't need a rotary cutter for this. That's true, but man, rotary cutters are awesome. Wow, the needle is barely peeking out from in there. Maybe I should have done a lighter color for the needle, but I don't know. We're here now. Alright, so here we go. There is our tiny needle peeking through. So you can, now you're starting to see that shape a little bit. Let's trim that up. Man, I think I should have gone a little lighter because we have all this detail and stuff going on here. Maybe when we're done, oh, I forgot, there's a little embroidery in here. So maybe I'll do some embroidery on here too or something to make it pop a little bit. We'll see. I think it'll be fine. I want the focus to be on the dress more anyway, but all right, let's trim this out right away. Let's find my ruler. Okay, so this is our edge, so I'm going to use that as my guide, and I'm going to put my quarter inch mark on that edge, and then we're going to trim our quarter inch all the way around here. Yeah, so when the floss goes through it, and maybe I'll add some embroidery floss to the actual needle. You know, maybe it's like a highlight on the needle or something like that. Maybe that will, some like a little shiny part on the needle. That could make it stand out a little, maybe. Or once it's all together, maybe we won't need it to stand out anymore. I don't know. We'll see. Last cut, then it'll start to look like something. Hopefully. Okay. right, there's our tiny little meat. Oh yeah, metallic floss. That's a good idea. I'll throw some metallic floss on the actual needle to make it kind of like shiny, like a shiny needle. And then we'll have like our pretty, maybe even red. Maybe we do red embroidery floss or yellow, red or yellow, something that pops for, if you look at the design here, there is some embroidery that we're going to have to do when we're done here. So that could be one of these bright colors. And then that could bring in some of these colors to this side. But all right, there we go. That's where this is going to go. And yeah, getting close to another one finished. Not quite, but getting there. Let's move on. So let's, I think we can get, I don't know, this only is three in. We might get both of these done tonight yet. We have a half hour. I don't think we'll get all of this done, but let's start seeing what we can do. All right, let's put these guys to the side for now. Or they can hang out here. They can hang out like they were by the sewing machine. It's kind of fun to see them every once in a while. Put the needle up there. Okay. L would be next. Ooh. Got all these little threads on my way. All right, L1. Okay, wait, what are my colors for this? All right, so here's what I have picked out for the needle and thread, or the thread, not the needle. So for the thread, I think I'm going to use this zigzag. I think that'd be kind of cute. Little zigzag there. It'll help bring in some of this red again. I'm just going to put this on this side for now so we can see it. And then I was thinking of just bringing back this, which is the trim for the dress. And that could be the base of the, or like the spool part. But maybe that would be okay. Kind of like that. And then in this case, then maybe I should be doing red thread since this is kind of red. So a red thread kind of coming through here. And then yeah, some sparkle thread through the needle, I think. So okay, that's the plan. So I need these two. Actually, I only need this for the L. So let's work on that. All right, L1 is my fabric here. Look, this is all I have left of this. This is it for this fabric. Ah, so sad. The poor little fabric's gonna be all gone. All right, you know what? I need a piece for this too. I mean, it's kind of the same. These are kind of the same, right? They're just mirrored. Oh, and then the top and bottom is a little different, but the LJ shape. The L1 and the J1 look the same, so I'm going to just cut two rectangles while I'm at it. I don't think, that's too small. I need a bigger seam allowance. I mean, I do think it's nice that I'm using the fabric, you know, but I definitely came from the camp of this fabric's too pretty, I can't use it. So, I don't know, I'm using it now. I think, let's see, how wide is this? Still trying to preserve it though. And you know what? I think I'm just gonna take a piece out of here. Maybe try and leave it up here a little bit. Why don't I put both on at once? So I need to leave that generous seam allowance. Go this way. Alright, so that's a pretty good seam allowance. There's a pretty good seam allowance, and then up here, and I do have a little nick out of it. So yeah, I think I'll have to cut all the way here. Alright, little fabric. Nick. I'll use my little scissors for that. I better check my unfinished blocks to see if any more of it needs this. I might have to put this to the side. So I have it. So there's a little nick up here that I have to watch for. I'm just going to cut this right down the middle. Down the middle. Okay. It's blended pretty. Okay. J's later. Let's do the L. I mean, I still did a pretty generous piece on both of these, but that's okay. I'd still rather err on doing it big enough. Yes, that's true. It will always be my quilt. That is very, very true. Susan, that is a good point. I needed to hear that. Oops. Wrong end. It's the first piece, so let's put a little dab of glue on it. Hold it in place. Alright, L1 is done. I think I am going to bring out, you know what, for all these blocks, all these pieces seem smaller than a quarter inch, so I am going to use the add an eighth for all of these. L2 is next. I need the postcard first. Covering up L1, exposing L2, forgetting about everything else. Yeah, it'll all blend together, I think. You know, I haven't laid out my quilt in a while. I still keep saying I'm going to do that, but I haven't yet. I need to. Okay, there we go. Add an eighth. L2 is back to this fabric, and look, we can use some of these crazy scraps. Yeah, I think I'm going to just use this as is. I'll just throw it up there, leave the selvage on for now. Just do the job, right? Oh, I gotta remember I do need that generous seam allowance, but I think I'm going to risk it. We might be a little shy here, but I don't care. I think we're good enough that it'll work. Alrighty. That needle wasn't nearly as difficult as I thought it was going to be. It still went pretty quick. And I mean, it was, you had to really stay on those lines so it's precise, and it did get kind of thick up at the top here. But I think it worked okay. Alright. Let's hope this works. Get these up next to each other a little bit. I am very close with this piece. It doesn't seem like that, but we gotta remember that it doesn't have, the seam allowances aren't included. Having that added eighth ruler would have made making this black much easier. I had never heard of the add a quarter ruler or add an anything ruler, before I started this, and, we were doing the first few paper piecing projects of the Splendid Sampler without it. And people kept saying, like, oh, I should get an add an eighth ruler, or add a quarter ruler, and I'm like, why would I grab and add a, like, why would I need that, you know what I mean? Because it just seems so frivolous, just, like, something to measure, like, a quarter inch that I already know how to measure. It just seemed weird, but oh my gosh, I'm so happy I got it. And then, when I was kind of struggling on that the balls in the air block, that's the one that had a lot of really small pieces. And then that's when someone mentioned the add an eighth ruler. And so I got one of those too. Kathleen, I think I'm doing mine without sashing. Just because I kind of like, I mean, I don't know. I'm not sure that's a good recommendation. But I just kind of graphically like when all my colors mush together so that blocks are blending into each other. Which may be kind of funny, but I kind of like that idea. So I'm not going to use sashing. I'm going to bunch all my 100 blocks. I might do like 110 because I have, I might do one more row. So I have a like 10 by 11. And I'm going to just mush them together. Like I'm going to blend colors together. It might look weird, but I kind of like that. And I think I'm going to just put a really big border around it. And I'm not sure what fabric I'll use for that yet either. But yeah, I want it to be our queen size. I want it for our bed, so that's queen size. So I'm hoping that will all work out. But I will definitely be doing that and just deciding all those things here on the Facebook Live too. I'm hoping that eventually at some point when we're ready, I'll head to my parents' house, and my mom's doing this quilt too, so we want to do it together. We want to do our final kind of sewing the top and stuff together. Oh my gosh, I can barely turn this piece. There we go. Add an eighth in there again. There we go. All my tools end up on this side, and I need them on this side. I'm not doing a good job of placement. I have to leave it over there, though. I don't have space over here. Yeah, I'm not sure. Oh, you know what? For backing, I think I'm going to take every single scrap that I have left over. Like, if I end up with this scrap, I'll just cut this square out of it, you know, a normal shape. Like, I'll cut a square here, and maybe I'll cut a smaller square. Ugh, that might be too intense. But I'll cut out this square, and, you know, I'll put all my pieces that I end up, like, all my fabric that I have left over, I think I'm going to use as the back. So that's going to be a whole collage mishmash of stuff. But all my fabric will get used then. And I'm hoping out of all my scraps, like, I've been saving all my scraps, like my sewing machine scraps and stuff. I've been making like new fabric out of that by, you know, sewing it all together. We've done that once or twice on here, and we'll do it again for sure. But I'm hoping to use up all my fabric that way as well. I think I have one tiny little scrap here. I'm wondering, oh yeah, that'll be good. I'm going to use this for this tiny little corner here. Oh my gosh, I can't even pick it up. So I'm just going to use this straight edge, plop it on there. Pretty sure that's plenty. I'm not even going to test it. All right, we'll flip that around. I love that you can use scraps with all these small paper pieced bits. Oh man, it's hard to pick it up though, it's so small. There we are. So I'm going to start and end in the seam allowance again. All right, here we go. Oh, you did? Oh, cool. Yeah, so I want to make more of that fabric out of all the scraps. So maybe when we're done, like if I get caught up on all the blocks eventually here at some point, maybe I'll just make a bunch of those all at once. I'd like to have, I only did one bonus block and that was at the beginning. So if I want to do this extra row of fabric or of blocks, I'll have that one bonus block that I did and then I need nine more. So I'd like to have nine of these collaged together out of all the scraps as blocks. Alternate sashing with every other block. Oh, checkerboard style. That'd be cute. Oops. Oh, I almost pressed the wrong direction. Ink side down. But yeah, so, and then I would pepper those collage blocks throughout the quilt, maybe? I don't know. That's still too far away. I can't think about that yet. I got, what is it, 86? Block 86 tomorrow? Oh wait, or is it block 87 already? 87. Hey, what is it? 86 or 87 tomorrow? Or Thursday, not tomorrow. Can't remember. Okay. It looks crazy still, but we're getting there. Last one, L4. Postcard right here. They said, boat. Have they said, oh, how to finish it yet? They're going to have a couple suggestions, but I think it's up to, oh, 86 tomorrow. Okay. It's ultimately up to you how you want to finish it. I think they are going to give a couple suggestions, like a couple ways that, like, you know, here's how it would look like with sashing, or here's, you know, a way of doing it. I'm not quite positive, but I think they are going to do two or three examples of that, or share a couple of examples of that. And we'll do the whole quilt. I'm not quite sure how I'm going to quilt mine yet. I might quilt it kind of simply. I'm not quite positive. That's too much thinking. All right, this is our last piece on this guy. I don't think I have any more scraps, so we're going to trim here. Yeah, I guess we'll just go all the way up the length of this, I suppose. First, let me get a straight edge. We'll just use the empty ruler. Alrighty. And I think I'll just cut it all the way up, and maybe we'll use it as a little piece later, too. Yeah, so I'm just going to go. I need my at least quarter inch seam allowance. So this is a bigger piece than you kind of expect, but we got to remember that we need that quarter inch. And you know what? I'm not even going to bother trimming that. I'm going to just sew with it because this is our last little piece, so I'm just going to deal with it. Yeah, we're going to go right there. So then I can cut off the selvage and all that at the same time. All right, here we go. I'm hoping to, Susan, I'm hoping to show the whole process. I mean, some of it, you know, it'll be hard to do, to show, you know, all the quilts, like my mom and my quilts laid out and stuff, but we have tripods that we can mount on things, so I might not be able to see it and talk the entire time, but I will have it, I'll have it on. I think we should do that. I think that'd be fun. So we'll figure out some way to do that, for sure. Oops, my pedal got funny. Oh, I know what feels weird. I'm sewing with my shoes on, and I'm thinking usually I don't do that. I'm losing a little bit of a feel of my, how much I'm pressing down and stuff. All right, into the seam allowance. You know what? I think I need to switch my needle after this, too. It feels like it keeps wanting to push the fabric into the machine, even on an area that's flat like this. So I'm thinking my needle needs a break. It needs a new needle in there, which makes sense. We've been doing a lot of paper piecing and we haven't switched the needle in a long time. So it's about time. I'm sure all this paper isn't, you know, making it any sharper. So I'll have to remember to do that. Before it causes too much trouble. All right, this is it for this little segment. We'll trim it yet. And then I think we might call it a night. And then tomorrow, so we still have the free day tomorrow. So I think we'll definitely easily get these two done. Slashing around. Oh, make it look like windows. Oh, that'd be cute. So we'll do these two tomorrow, and I think we'll still have a little bit of time to start piecing all of them together. I'm not sure anything, well, I guess these have to match up, but other than that, nothing really has to match up. So putting the pieces together, I think will go pretty quickly. So we'll try and do these two plus putting it together tomorrow. I don't know. We might just go until we're done tomorrow, just because it'd be awesome to be done. but then we still have to tear out all the papers and everything. I always forget about that. That always takes time. And we'll see how it goes. You know what? We might have time tonight yet. We have 10 minutes. We could maybe whip through three little bits. That'll give us a little bit more time, right? I think let's try and get through that piece quick. Just rectangles, that shouldn't be too difficult. Yeah, let's do that. We're gonna do that piece tonight too. Alright. There we are. Here is that's the bottom, right? Yeah, the bottom of our actually on this side. So here's our needle. This will be our bottom of our thread. Fun. All right, let's do this guy really quick. and then we'll do that guy tomorrow. All right, for this, oh yeah, I gotta remember, we already cut out a piece for this. This goes together. K1, that's that middle area that I'm doing in this. Oh man, you know what? I better check to see if I have a scrap. It'd be sad to cut that in if I have a little scrap hiding in here. It's a pretty big, I need a kind of a bigger scrap than what I think I have. Oh, and I don't, oh, here. That's way too small. This looks like my only scrap of that fabric in here. I must have used it for some other stuff, which is good. So, all right, let's open up this. Let's see, can we get it right here? Oh, yeah, that's plenty good. I need to put in, oops. Oh, I swear I didn't need to flip it. I I'm always used to putting the right side down when doing this, so I think I just got in the habit, but I didn't really need to do that here because it's just a simple rectangle. All right, that looks good. Go about there, kind of right there. All right, done with that fabric. We didn't need that for much. All right, let's put our little dab of glue in the center there. Okay, I'm kind of going to try and put this straight so our thread is going kind of straight on the spool. Alright, I think that did it. Alright, two pieces. We can do that. Out of here. So, well, you know what? First of all, let's do our postcard. Still gotta do the steps in order, I suppose. K2. I'm gonna use the add a quarter again. I like using the add a quarter better. I like having the bigger seam allowance. Alright. Uh-oh. Need to change my blade still. Haven't done that. K2, I think we're going to try and get you right here. So I'm just going to kind of do a little straight edge cut right here and about there. Alright. See if that does the job. I'm sure that's more than enough. It has a selvage on there too, so I'm kind of dealing with that. All right, let's sew that. And I'm going to start in the seam allowance. Actually. Alright, I think we're good. We're good enough, at least. I forgot that I hadn't sewn anything yet, so nothing was really holding this K1 piece down except for the glue, and I think that moved a little bit, but it's just these big rectangles. We should be fine. Cute. All right, I'm excited. Let's press that, and then we just have that one more piece and trimming it. And we should be good. Alrighty. There we go. Oh, you know what? I did something that I wasn't gonna do. I was going to leave extra seam allowance. I wasn't going to trim on the edges. I didn't trim on this side because I wanted it, in case my thing shrunk, I wanted to be able to cut it down, but, you know, it's too late now, so I'll just keep trimming. Right, K3, we got that guy to do yet. So let's get the postcard out. Last piece of the night. I think it can fit right in there pretty well. I'm just going to cut it right about there. Across. There we go. This does have a little nick in, so hopefully I'm going to err on the side of doing it a little lower. Kind of spider webby, but I'm gonna pretend it's starry instead of spider webby. Alright. Flip that around. Starting in the seam allowance again. That's it for sewing. Oops. There we go. Let's press it and... Oh, thanks, Jennifer. I'm excited about the dress. But we'll press this and then we'll trim it. And then we'll call it a night. So then all we have to do is this little top and sew the whole thing together. And I think now that we've gotten one extra piece done just now, I think we'll be able to do that. Okay. Oops. Are you guys talking about stashing? I think 1.5 would be really pretty. So it'd be nice and thin. We're trimming. That's what we're at. I'm like, what step are we on? What number is next? But we're done with numbers. We're just trimming now. All right. Let's do our 1/4 inch all the way around. I don't know. Maybe I'll end up doing a sashing still. I kind of like the idea of them all blending together, but, you know, with sashing, then they all stand out as individual blocks, too, which, I don't know, would be pretty, too. I can't decide. In my head, I guess, if I do all the blacks mashed together, then that will be sitting on the top of the bed. And then if I do it with a big border, the border will be the part that hangs over the bed. I think that's kind of, it'll be like framed by a really big border. That's kind of, I think, what I'm thinking about. We'll see. I got a little time yet. All right. Oh, wait. So we're getting there, and then all we have left is this little jobby on the top, and then we're getting there. Check it out. I never thought I'd be this far on this guy. Oh, it's been a while. So this is, like I said, this is my second oldest block, block 28. I have one a little older than this, but this one has been around for a while, so it's so nice to get it farther. I kind of like this red in here. We'll have, it's almost pink, I suppose. So I'll have a red thread coming through here. But all right, guys, that's we'll call that for the night. We got three units done. That's pretty good for us. Usually we only end up getting like two done, so I don't know. And this one had five in, so it's almost like we got 2 5-unit things done tonight. That's pretty good. So, all right, I'm going to flip you around, and we'll call it an evening. Hey there again. So here is how small that needle is. Like, it's nothing. Isn't that crazy? It's so little. All right, I'm pretty confident that we'll be able to finish this tonight. I wasn't sure if we'd get it, but yeah, I think tomorrow this will be a done block, and then we will be 14 behind. That's so much better than 17 behind. I'm excited. And then I think for Saturday, I'm going to do that 4 hours on Saturday again. I think we're going to stick with paper piecing for a little while yet. So I don't know what Thursday's block is going to be though. So I'm excited to see that. But anyway, this will go up on Penguin and Fish Movies on YouTube again, and it should stay on the Penguin and Fish Facebook page as well. So I'll get that up there tonight for you guys. And thanks again. I love having you guys here. I'll see you tomorrow at 9:30. Good night, guys.